Dear me, where do I start? It's been about a year since the world was shaken, rocked to its core.
From this evening, I must give the British people a very simple instruction. You must stay at home.
We had no idea when that first announcement was made that we'd still be stuck at home. Still separated from our family and friends. The classrooms are still empty, and this generation of young people are having a hard time adjusting to school being online, as are their parents and their teachers. It's been an intense time for our leaders, navigating the impact of this horrible virus on our nation, on our world. Key workers continue to put themselves at risk to make sure the country still runs. Cleaners, bus drivers, shop assistants, nurses and doctors, just to name a few. I've heard of so many that have lost their lives. The death toll just kept growing. So many people have felt the pain of death and loss all over the world. Death isn't the only loss we've seen. There's been a loss of connection, loss of community, loss of comfort and security. People are shielding, people are stranded, people are separated. Loneliness has become a harsh reality for many, especially those who live by themselves. It's been a year of disappointment, exams cancelled, weddings cancelled, businesses shut, and so many hard-working people left without a job. It's been a year that calls for grieving and remembering all the loss and pain. That's okay. And that's important. It's nearly Easter here. And at Easter we celebrate a God who came to earth and suffered greatly and was drawn in compassion to those who suffered. He stops for the one. He sees us in our pain. And he deeply loves us. He offers redemption in all circumstances. His resurrection triumphed over death. Dear me, this year is going to be overwhelming. There's no question about that. But in it, may you be overwhelmed by his love.